Okay, on to actual content. And this time I'm armed with a pen. Expressions. Okay, expressions allow us to express computation in programming languages. So an expression is something that describes some piece of computation and evaluates to a value. Both these are important. So expressions are older than computers. Mathematics contains all kinds of expressions. But mathematicians invented tons of different ways of writing things down. So when you want to add in math, you put a plus sign in between the two things you want to add. But division's totally different. You put something above and something below, a horizontal line. Square roots involve putting a number in a little house. Taking the sine of an angle. You usually write sin instead of sine because apparently the E takes too long to write. And there are all these other different kinds of mathematical notation that people have developed over the years. Well, it turns out that there's just one type of expression to rule them all. And that's the function notation. That one. That's the one that computer scientists use because it's a generalization over everything else. So all expressions can be expressed using function call notation, like f of x. Okay, enough slides. Let's take a look. So I'm going to start up Python here. And I'll show you that what Python does is it waits for you to type in an expression. We'll type in 2013. And it'll evaluate that expression, because expressions describe computations and they have values. And in this case, 2013 just evaluates to 2013. But we can do fancier stuff than that. So we can add together 2013. It does addition. We can even add together multiple things at the same time. Maybe do a little multiplication in there. And super quick, Python's gonna do the math for us. Okay, so it's capable of using what we call infix operators, which are things like times and plus, where you put the arguments to those operators on the left and the right, because that's just mathematical convention. But most of what we're going to write in this course uses instead function call notation. So that means writing down the name of a function and then the arguments to that function. What's the max of 2 and 4? It's 4. What's the min of negative 2 and 50,000? Negative 2. What's 100 to the second power? That's 100 times 100 is 10,000. That's a really big number. Maybe we can get an even bigger number by taking 2 to the 100th. Okay, so that's what function notation looks like in Python. As we're writing down call expressions, and Python is evaluating them for us. Now, even addition and multiplication can be expressed using function call notation or call expressions. But to do that, we need to make sure that we have access to the functions that represent addition and multiplication. So we'll talk more about this line later. But basically, add and mul didn't mean anything before. Even though they're part of the programming language, we had to go get them from this module of different functions called operator. Okay, so now we can add together 2 and 3 to get 5. We can multiply together 2 and 3, and that will give us 2 times 3 is 6. And with function notation, it's particularly expressive because you can nest it. So we can say mul add 2 and multiply together 4 and 6. And what are we multiplying all that with? Well, the result of adding together 3 and 5, and we get 208. Okay, let's take a look at exactly what's going on there. So a call expression in Python looks like this. Here's an example. That whole thing is a call expression. And it has some parts, and those parts have names. And I'll use those names all the time in this course, so you should learn them now. What comes before the parentheses is called the operator. And what comes within the parentheses separated by commas are operands. Operators and operands are expressions themselves. So the whole thing is a call expression. See if I can do this. Okay. This whole thing is a call expression. But these things I've underlined are also expressions. So they evaluate to values. That's what expressions do. Now, in order to evaluate a whole call expression, we have a procedure for evaluating them. And it goes like this. The evaluation procedure for call expressions first evaluates the operator and then the operand sub-expressions. So here's the operator. Here's the operands. Those get evaluated to their values. Now the operator is going to give us a function, which we're going to apply to two values in this case, which are the two arguments to that function. So the function is add, and the two arguments are going to be 2 and 3, the things we add together. Okay, so that's step one, is we get add, the function, we get 2 and 3, the things we're adding together, and then step two is we apply the function that's the value of the operator sub-expression to the arguments that are the values of the operand sub-expressions. Okay, so let's see if my pen works. Evaluating the name add gives us a function. Evaluating 2 and 3 give us the arguments that we're going to add together. And then the whole thing evaluates to 5. Okay, I know that felt like super slow motion for figuring out how to add 2 and 3 together. But now when we turn to the more complex example, we can just apply this evaluation procedure over and over again. So this is what we evaluated. Mol add 2, mol 4, 6, add 3, 5, with a bunch of parentheses, a bunch of commas. What's going on here? Well, we want to evaluate this whole call expression. In order to do that, we have to apply the procedure for evaluating call expressions, which means evaluate the operator, that gives us the multiplication function, evaluate the operands, here's the first operand, oh, it's also a call expression. I better apply my rule for evaluating call expressions, which means I evaluate that operator, I get the add function, I evaluate the operands, 2 evaluates to 2, and mol 4, 6 is another call expression, so I apply that same procedure again. Evaluate mol, 4 and 6 to get multiplication of 4 and 6, which finally gives me a value, 24. Okay, now we're making progress. So here we are. We can now add together 2 and 24 because that's the function and the two arguments of this call expression, at which point we get 26. So 26 is something we're going to multiply together with whatever is the value of adding 3 and 5. So to evaluate add 3, 5, which is another call expression, we figure out add is a function, 3 and 5 are numbers that we can add together, and we get 8. Multiplying together, 26 and 8 gives us 208. This whole thing I've drawn is called an expression tree. It's just a diagram of the computational process that's used in order to evaluate a call expression. So the call expression we evaluated is that big thing at the top. It had an operand sub-expression. And the value of that operand is called an argument to the function named by the operator. So those are all the pieces, is that operands are expressions and arguments are their values. And then eventually we get to the value of the whole expression.